Hello, everybody. This is Danny S. Hodges. This is the ultimate TV antenna versus the store bought DB8. First of all, I want to tell y'all I ain't real happy about this right here. I've kind of changed my mind about it, but I done promised I would do it, so I'm going to fulfill it out. I ain't going to show the antenna good. I done told you in my other video, I don't think there's no difference between one and another. I'm going to give you a little bit of a rundown here about what I've got right here. Okay, I've got the store-bought antenna hooked up right now. And I've had that thing hooked up about 7 days, and I'm ready for it to go. I'm going to back off here and show you this. And this is where my couch is right here. You see, I got my laptop there. And you see, I got another little small TV there. And, which I got that on VHF. I got both of them on VHF right now. And, anyway, even, you know, I told you I got satellite. And even when I got these TVs, this TV right here on my main TV, even when I got it on the satellite, I'm still monitoring the TV antenna right here like while I'm laying on the couch. So I've been studying this right here. And y'all, just in 1 week's time, especially in a month's time, I've learned so much, it is pitiful. And I can't tell you everything I learned. I mean, I could if you got about 2 hours. But I want to tell you one thing that is important. Well, a couple of things is important. Like how straight all your whiskers is, how perfect cut they all are, how perfect you make that antenna matters. And I'm going to do a channel scan in a second, but I'm going to kind of just bouncing around telling you some stuff that I know. You know, I got a rotor here. Here it is right here. And I just got a drop cord has got 3 wires in it. And that's what you need. So see, you can buy a cheap drop cord and use it for a rotor wire. Okay, now back to what I was saying. You know, it's a wonder I ain't wore the rotor out turning it and stuff. And sometimes this thing will come in good, you know, like on that million watt channel. And I take that rotor and turn it all the way around backwards, and it'll completely go out. And with the ultimate antenna, you can turn it around backwards, and it'll still be picking up. So see, that right there goes right along with what I'm saying. Go to menu here, and I'm going to just simply do a channel scan. This antenna is barefooted, but I'm going to do the ultimate. When I do the channel scan on the ultimate, it's going to be barefooted in the same situation. While that's scanning right there, I'm going to show you this right here. Here's my wire coming in from my antenna. You can see it's running into a splitter. But it's one of them kind of splitters that don't have no loss. There's two different people told me about that, and I didn't even know you could buy a splitter that didn't have no loss. Okay, so it splits into the one wire there. And then see how I got this right here? It splits into another where it's running both of the laptop. I mean the TV and the laptop. You say, well, that ain't fair. It is fair too, because the ultimate antenna is going to be tested the same way. And you see that right here? And you know our normal channels is 21 channels. So watch it. It's going to go from 58.3, 58.4. Hey, I ain't even never even seen that channel. but it ain't. It picked it up, but it ain't coming in. And see, it went from that 7 to the 24. It missed channel 13, which is a major channel around here. And that's a CBS VHF channel here. And I found out that CBS ain't necessarily on VHF all over the United States. And I'll see if this other channel, you know, I'd have been messing with it, you know. Well, I've been nonstop messing with it, is what I've been doing. Okay, see, that's the Dublin channel. And I'm hitting reverse. And there's a channel 29 right there. That's a VHF channel. See, it's missing. I'm just going back and forth right here. It's missing that channel. And I forgot how many channels it even said it was getting. I'm fitting to go up on the roof, and then I'm going to come back and do the channel scan on the ultimate antenna. All right, y'all, I'm fitting to do a scan. I got up there and swapped the antennas. It took me a minute because I had to come down. I left my snips. So, man, I'm tired of that mess. But when I come back down, this right here was working. Okay, I'm going to do the channel scan. Still the same deal. All right. Here we go. I'll fast forward it. Menu. Auto program start. And y'all, one of the things that like kind of aggravates me is I can't make you know enough about how good that ultimate antenna is. I'm one of them kind of people, you know how you have to take some stuff that people say with a grain of salt. I ain't one of them. As a matter of fact, I can't even hardly talk for trying to tell it like something just exactly like what it is. That's kind of one of my hang-ups. Okay, it's about to wind down here. Y'all don't worry about that 21 channels is all I'm getting, because that's all that we have available, except for like when that skip's coming in there. But let me set this down. I'll show you VHF. I like to never figured out the zoom on it. I'll go to the channel that the other antenna missed. Look at that. You know, I can't sit and tell you enough how important, like, your antenna is. Like, the way it's soldered together, the one I just took down, the elements is screwed on with a screwdriver. This right here is soldered. That means your grandyoungins will be able to watch this antenna. Let's see. Let me go to... That right there is VHF. Okay, y'all. This is like 30 minutes later. I'd have been looking over the footage. I didn't realize that I didn't show the signal strength of the CBS emblem right here. And if you can't tell, that's every bar lit up. That ultimate antenna's bad through the bone. Let me set this down, and I'll turn it to the other channel. That 29 that it missed a while ago. Here it is. Okay, see, that's every channel right. That's every bar lit up. And I want to tell y'all something. That dude that you see commenting, his name is Google User. Be paying attention to what he says. That man is very smart. I've like been seeing his comments for the longest. But he can tell you why this ultimate antenna is as good as it is. All right, y'all. I'm going to take y'all out with this right here. A lot of people is kind of like over worried about this right here. I'm going to take my rotor and turn it around backwards. And I want to tell you today is a good antenna day too. I've watched that other antenna pixelating until I just can't hardly stand it no more. But I'm going to show you this right here. Here's my rotor. I'm going to turn it around backwards. And y'all, just because my antenna's got a reflector on it, don't mean it won't pick up. Okay, look here. I'm going to turn in the rotor. Watch how this does. Now, I would catch that other antenna. I would catch it, you know, like when it was picking up good, and I turn it all the way around backwards, it goes slam out. I mean, it's... Well, anyway, you know what I'm talking about. It loses it all. I don't understand it. Okay, that was the mail lady at the door. That's the reason I ran off. But see that right there? When y'all doing this, point your antenna to the weakest station. And anyway, see the rotor right there? Matter of fact, I turn it back. How about that? Thanks, everybody. We'll see y'all next time. Don't forget to like and subscribe.